Unlock Positivity with Sadhguru, an initiative by Isha Foundation and Big FM.
Namaskaram, Sadhguru. It's like a half dream come true. I always wanted to meet you, but okay, I'm meeting you in a virtual space. So I'm still contented with that. Sadhguru, it generally happens when somebody asks you to sing a song, you cannot recall of any song at that moment, right? And similarly, when somebody asks you to ask you a question, you cannot think of anything, though there are many things in your mind. But the one thing that I can really think of to ask you is, like, we were watching in that AV also, where you say, same divine is in all, it's in everyone. So in that way, do you believe in right and wrong? I mean, when we say that it's the same divine in everyone, and then we also say, hate the sin, not the sinner. So sometimes it happens.
I did not say that.
No, I said something. They say. Not you. So, do you believe in the concept of right and wrong? And then if somebody is doing wrong, is it that divine that is doing it wrong? Or, you know, I get confused thinking about all these things sometimes. And sometimes, you know, it happens with myself also. I know what I'm doing is wrong, but I don't want to stop myself, because stopping myself is difficult. It's more painful than...
That is also wrong. Stopping yourself also is wrong.
So what to do in that case? Thank you.
See, this right and wrong, people have been debating forever, for thousands of years. Never one debate has come to a proper conclusion as to what is right and what is wrong. Because what is right and what is wrong, in a very fundamental, rudimentary way, if you ask me, what I do is right, what you do must be wrong. This is the basis of right and wrong arguments between people. So constantly fightings are going on, arguments are going on, right now LAC is going on, you know, what is right, what is wrong? They have one right, we have another right. Well, we will fight for it because we think this is right, that's a different matter. But the important thing is, we must understand that right and wrong exists only in human minds. This existence of right and wrong in your mind is a consequence of social culturing that's happened to you. In different societies, different people think what is right, what is wrong is very different from society to society. And as you know, from generation to generation, what your parents think is right is not right for you, what they think is wrong is perfect for you. All these things are there. So this is an endless process, because this is a psychological and social phenomena. It is not an existential reality. Nowhere in the existence is there a judgment to say this is right, this is wrong. So what should you do? What you should do is, what is best for maximum number of lives around you? Because even in that there is no agreement. If you do something right to 10 people, 1 person will be angry about it endlessly. So what you see as maximum well-being to maximum number of people, that's what you do, because there is no right and wrong. It is only in terms of, do our actions support life or negate life? This is all the question is. So you do not act out of your morality of right and wrong, you act out of your humanity. This is most important. And about these things go on endlessly. Can I tell you a little story, Juhi? So, I'm in Tennessee right now. Tennessee at one time, if you know, it was known for bootlegging or moonshining, as it was called. That means because alcohol was illegal in United States, you can't believe that now, but it was illegal, so everybody was brewing, particularly in Tennessee. Every cave, every house, every backyard, they were brewing their own whiskey and selling it all over. Some of them have survived the famous name, others have gone down. Every home had their own still to make these things. So there were two brothers who were bootleggers. So one of them died. So the other brother, none of the churches were willing to allow, you know, really come and do the service for his death. Then the brother went to one pastor and said, see, I know you need to build a new church. Here it is, I give you $25,000. But I want you to do a service for my brother, and you must say he was a saint. The pastor looked at $25,000 check and said, okay. Then when the service came, people gathered and he said, this man who is dead here right now was a sinner of the worst kind. He committed every kind of sin, every kind of immoral things that he can do. He was a drunkard, he was a debaucher, he was a cheat, he was a murderer, he was a rapist, he was everything. But compared to his brother, he is a saint.
Unlock positivity with Sadhguru, an initiative by Isha Foundation and Big FM.